Hey, what's up guys? This video here, we're going to talk about the SL variant speed loader. I get a lot of private messages and comments about this speed loader. People always ask me, why do I endorse it? Why am I so enthusiastic about it? Why do I advocate this speed loader so much for somebody that carries a revolver on the streets or as a CCW defensive weapon? Well, that's quite simple. The design of this speed loader is ingenious. Okay, it's made in Germany. And we all know Germans know how to make cars and guns like Heckler & Koch, Mercedes, Volkswagen, Audi, BMW, and so on. The engineering of this is just ingenious. As you can see, each charging hole has a spring. They're spring-loaded, so when you put the rounds in here, it's locked in, okay? And when you slam this into the cylinder, this centerpiece right there gets depressed, and that's when these springs are released with tension. And those rounds are punched out and into your cylinder. And that's it. Take this thing, punch it in, you're set to go. Very simple. Less malfunctions, meaning I find the SL variant superior to the old school HKS, because the HKS, you gotta, you know, twist a knob, what have you, and hope that all those rounds with gravity, okay, fall out. Sometimes when you pull this thing out prematurely, you're pulling the rounds right out of the cylinder. You know, sometimes they don't all come out. You got to wiggle it. You got to spin the cylinder to get this stuff out of there. So that's old school. Safari Land Comp 2. I'm not a fan of this one either, just because I've had issues with this for whatever reason, locking in the rounds. Okay. And then when you punch this in, it's kind of similar to that SL variant. Sometimes this gets hung up on. It doesn't want to push in. Well, now it is, but you know, sometimes I had a little issue with that and the rounds weren't dropping out. So, not really liking that. I didn't bring it down, but the 5-star aluminum billet speed loader, I'm not a fan of that one either, just because it's really loose with the rounds and you can shake it. It sounds like a maraca. Also, when you're trying to punch it in under stress, the rounds are just moving around too much and you're having a little bit of trouble. With the SL variant, you can twist this knob here and kind of control the spread of the rounds. But normally, let's load it up with some snap caps. Normally, there's not an issue there. I just leave it stock. Leave it stock. But here, let's see what it looks like. Basically, punching them in like that. You can hear an audible click when they're getting locked in there, the rounds. And there you go. There's your SL variant. Now, the jet loader is another speed loader that's sort of similar to this. But there's a guy at the range that has one, and that's more for competition. I did have a nice like handle that screwed on here, so I extended the handle out to there. So it kind of looked like a jet loader. I lost the handle at the range. I don't know what happened. I must have dropped it somewhere, but oh well. But you could get something and spin it on there, and then you would have a larger handle if you wanted to use these in competition. But realistically, these are for street use, defensive use. SL variant is definitely something that you should have on you if you carry a revolver. I first learned about SL variant maybe 2 years ago at the range. I was practicing with my 642 when I saw another individual practicing with their 340 PD. And I was watching him shoot, and I was watching him reload that freaking little J-frame so fast with some type of speed loader. I had to go up to him and ask him, what is that? And he told me it was SL variant, and he told me how to get it. Now, these are, you know, a little pricey, coming in at $30, you know, plus shipping. So it is expensive. There is another speed loader that I wanted to try out called Max Fire. I think it's like a big rubber piece. And I might buy one of those just to check it out, just to kind of see how those things work. Because someone told me Max Fire speed loaders are pretty cool. And a little, you know, less inexpensive than this, which is, you know, like I said, $30 plus shipping. I don't know. If you have a Max Fire speed loader, leave some comments. So where can you get these? Well, you can get these speed loaders from this guy here, which is Bobby Max. Okay, that's his information. Some people PM me stating that they had ordered from him, and there's like a really slow lag time in getting the speed loader. I'm not sure, but I guess it's been like almost three weeks before you get it. But I think most people want the one for the J-frame, the 5-shot, and I don't believe they make that one anymore. I don't know, someone else told me here on YouTube, said that SL variant is not even around anymore. I don't know. And you know what? you can go on eBay and find a used 5-shot SL variant and pay about 70 bucks for it. Would I do that? I don't know. That's a lot of money for a speed loader, but that's how desirable these freaking things are. 70 bucks, but they are, to me, again, I find them very necessary. I have two left for the 5-shot, and I have a, you know, three of these. I have, well, two right here for the 6-shot. So let me show you how it works quickly. All right, we got a cylinder there. We put it in like that, okay? And there you go. That's how easy it is to load. So, guys, if you have any comments or questions about the SL variant, please leave them below. Or you got any questions for me about the SL variant, because I have a lot of experience with these things, just send me a PM. But again, if you want to get one of these, go to this guy's website, because I think he's the only one. He's the only one that probably has these right now. So check them out. SL variant, by get them at Bobby Max right there. A little over 30 bucks, but definitely well worth it. As you can see, it's very simple to use. So, okay, guys, as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.